Now let us consider the hydrolysis of alkenes. Now next chemical reaction of alkenes, that is the hydrolysis of alkene. You know that alkene contain carbon-carbon double bond in their molecule. Now here alkene will reacts with the cold and dilute alkaline potassium permanganate KMNO4. It forms the glycols. Glycols contain two hydroxyl groups in their molecules. So they are also called as the 1,2-diols or glycols. Now ethene when reacts with this alkaline KMNO4 in the presence of water, then there is formation of the nascent oxygen atom. This is the nascent oxygen atom. And this ethene when reacts with the water molecule in the presence of this nascent oxygen. How the nascent oxygens are formed? Nascent oxygen is formed from the alkaline potassium permanganate. Now this O and this H again form the one of the hydroxyl group, OH group. One OH group is there in water. Two OH group gets added into this carbon-carbon double bond, and both of the carbon atom obtain one of the hydroxyl group, one hydroxyl group, and there is formation of ethane 1,2-diol. This is ethane 1,2-diol, or it is also called as the commonly ethylene glycol. Now again, any alkene can forms the 1,2-diol or glycol when reacts with the alkaline potassium permanganate in the presence of nascent oxygen. Now see, this is the propene because it contains three carbon atoms and there is double bond between these two carbon atoms. So the OH group adds between these two carbon atoms. So propene in the presence of water molecule and in nascent oxygen in the presence of alkaline potassium permanganate forms the propane 1,2-diol. Now see this, this CH3 is as it is, this CH has OH, CH2 has OH. Now this is the 1, 2, 3 as the number are there. So it is 1,2-diol, propane 1,2-diol, or commonly it is called as the propylene glycol. In this way, after the hydrolysis or hydrolation of the alkene, we obtain the 1,2-diol or glycols. Now when this is the reaction with alkaline potassium permanganate, but if we do the reaction with acidic potassium permanganate, there is oxidation of the alkene. Now during hydrolysis, alkenes in the presence of alkaline KMNO4, the color of the alkaline KMNO4, that is the magenta color or the purple color, dark purple color of the potassium permanganate disappears, because and there is formation of precipitation of the, that is the glycol is found there, and this test is used for the detection of double bond in the alkenes. So this test is also called as the Bayer's test. Bayer test is name of the scientist Bayer's, because during hydroxylation of alkene, the purple color of the KMNO4 disappears and there is synthesis of 1,2-glycol. So the qualitative test, so this qualitative test is used for the detection of the double bond in the alkene, and this test is called as the Bayer's test. This test is called as the Bayer's test. Now next is the reaction with the, that is acidic KMNO4, potassium permanganate. Now here also nascent oxygen atoms are formed. Four nascent oxygen atoms are formed when we use the acidic KMNO4 or potassium permanganate in the presence of acid. Now see, this is the propene. Now here is the breaking of the carbon-carbon double bond, and we obtain the CH3s. Directly oxygen gets added into this H, that is the, and OH, one of the hydrogen atom and oxygen atom form the, that is the acetic acid. Now in this way carboxylic acid is formed after the oxidation of the alkenes in the presence of acidified potassium permanganate. Or they may be given the ketones also. Now there is again the formation of carbon dioxide and water as the byproduct, and the reaction get balance here. Now see, alkenes on oxidation with, that is the acidic ethanoic acid. So alkenes on oxidation gives the acid, that is the ethanoic acid, that is acidic acid. And K1O4 also gives the ketones as an acid. Now say acid, acidic K1O4 gives. Now this acidic acid is called as the ethanoic acid here. And the alkenes on oxidation with acidic K1O4 gives ketones and carboxylic acid. Now this is the another alkene. The name of this alkene is 2-methyl-butyl-2-ENE. Why it is 2-methyl-butyl-2-ENE? Because numbering is done from this side. 1, 2, 3, 4. On the second carbon there is the methyl group and there are 4 carbon atoms in the chain, and there is double bond on the second carbon atom. So it is 2-methyl-butyl-2-ENE. Heat on oxidation with acidified potassium permanganate gives the nascent oxygen, and in the nascent oxygen they form the acetone and acetic acid. Here is the carbon-carbon double bond. Acetone is formed from this group and acetic acid is formed from this group. Now this is the oxidation of the alkenes. Now these are the two important reactions, hydroxylation and oxidation of the alkene by using the potassium permanganate. But for hydroxylation, alkaline K1O4 is used, and for the oxidation, acidic K1O4, that means potassium permanganates are used. And on oxidation, these alkenes give the ketones and carboxylic acids. Now this is the main reaction. Now see the reaction. If you like the video, you can share, you can subscribe, and you share the other students also. Thank you.